They say this is a big rich town. I just come from the poorest part. Bright light city life, I gotta make it. This is where it goes down. I just happen to come up hard. Legal or illegal, baby, I gotta make
I never
it.
Took
Finally, it is time. Power is back. If this is your first time tuning into this channel, make sure that you please like and subscribe. We are going to do this every week, reviewing the Power episodes. Each and every week, we're going to ride out the entire season. So please like and subscribe to get these views up on this review. What's interesting is while I was just waiting like everyone else for the show to come back on, I found maybe two or three websites or articles, blogs, YouTube pages that even highlighted Power, but every single person that I know watches it. And in turn, I also noticed that Power has not even won that many awards. So this is me showing love to my absolute favorite TV show because it is so great. From the writing to the acting, it's amazing. So we're going to get right into it for season 6, episode 1. Okay, so let's absolutely talk about the intro. We hated it. Hated it. I love Trey Songz. I am from Virginia. I mean, my high school was right up the street from where he's from. I used to buy his mixtapes while I was buying burgers at Andrew's Grill in Petersburg. Love him. But that was not it at all. Trey has this like very soft voice when he sings. He can sing about gritty content, but his voice isn't very like strong. And the entire intro has like a softer, more melodic beat. It's just not it. This is a very deep and, you know, gritty type of show. So we need Joe, the original version, back because he has that kind of gritty, raspy, nasty voice. Like, that's what we need. Like, that Anthony Hamilton and Joe, like, they all kind of just got that, like, like, that's what we need. And I just hope this is not an indication of, like, how the season is going to go, because I was not feeling that intro. The pain. So the show opens up to letting us relive what happened with Angie and her, you know, her last words to Ghost being that she loved him. Then she looks up, sees Tommy with that thing, pushes Ghost out the way, and she's hitting the chest. So we open back up to that and just, you know, them rushing her to the hospital, and James has the blood on him, and just that pain in Ghost's face, like, as he's there and he's yelling at the hospital workers, like, no, I got to go in there. And the hospital's like, are you her husband? And he's like, not quite. Let that be a lesson. Don't matter how much history y'all have, whatever, whatever, unless you got them papers, you got to go in the waiting room. But that's neither here nor there. So then we go to Tasha and Tommy talking about what happened. And when Tasha, you know, Tommy was telling her, like, I shot the bitch and, you know, I shot her in her chest. And Tasha's like, you don't even know if she's dead. Like, that was such a heated thing. And I just love the expression that was shown on Tommy's face at that point, because you can tell Tommy's having like this internal struggle of just like, shit, that bitch deserved it. You know, Ghost did me dirty, versus, oh shit, what did I just do? That's federal agent. Like, what is going on? And when Tasha dropped that line, you took a shot at the devil and missed? Woo, child. I was like, ooh, sis. Yes, again, the brilliance of the writing that is in Power. I love this show. So the mystery of, is Angela dead? Is Angela alive? Comes out when her sister Paz comes running in and she sees Jamie, and she immediately starts hitting him and saying, murderer, murderer. And you just see Ghost turn white. Ghost was Casper that day, bitch. Like, he was like, she's what? Like, just speechless. And you gotta love Power. I mean, this is the same show who killed off Raina. I mean, they killed off Kanan. This show has no mercy. And then they let us know that Angela was dead in the first 3 minutes of the show. Most of these shows would have dragged it out and, you know, kept us like anxiously waiting. Power gave it to us right there. And it cuts to the scene of the all of the other AUSAs and the U.S. attorney all standing in the room kind of talking about it. And they're kind of pointing out, you know, it's ghost. You know, Sax is saying it's ghost, it's ghost. And I love it that it's shot that you see the black attorney, Jerry, in the Howard University sweatshirt. I'm like, yes, on that black AUSA. But then at the same time, I'm like, we have to be cautious of, we continue to see Howard and other HBCUs inserted into pop culture. We also got to make sure that we're taking care of those HBCUs, because I personally know some Howard students and they don't even have AC in their classrooms. Their dorms need to be renovated. I mean, they need funding. So the same way we're buying these sweatshirts, we got to make sure that we're like pouring into the universities that look so dope on TV. But back to Power. And I also love that the U.S. attorney, Tamika, is a black lady in charge with that old nasty bob. She was giving me Annalise vibes from How to Get Away with Murder. I was like, okay. And she was like, this is a dangerous ass job. You damn right, because Angela dead, bitch. And just to see Angie's like lifeless body and her sister holding her hand. I love Pie since her character in Orange is the New Black. So every time I see her, I'm just like, oh. That was definitely like a heartwarming scene. And Sax comes in and he's getting Paz to agree to do the autopsy, which I feel her. You have to be cautious of that. Like, y'all not about to just be mutilating my sister's body, stealing organs. Like, what's up? What y'all doing? But in order to convict whoever did do this, she has to consider it. So that in itself is tricky. And it made me think, like, I'm like, dang, like, if that was up to me, would I want a family member to want to go through that, or would I want to find their killer? Good question. Then we go to Keisha, and she just wants to be Miss Ride or Die. I mean, balls to the wall. I'm a ride for my man till we everything, like, doing the most. So she goes and she meets Tommy, and Tommy gives her the gun that was used to kill a federal agent. She doesn't know this, but she takes the gun and puts it in her bag. Again, trying to be a ride or die. Tommy just pulls off. She's just standing there looking crazy. Tommy goes into his house and he already know what time it is. Ghost is lurking in them damn shadows. He got that name for a reason, honey. And he gave us what we've been waiting for 6 seasons. Finally, him and Tommy like squaring off. Like, it's crazy intense. Like, you can't even tell who's winning, because it's like both of them are getting the best of each other. And then, of course, here come worsome ass Tyreek coming in. I mean, I guess for once he did something good, because he did stop them from fighting. And that's the one thing that I love, the writers keep showing us, that no matter what is going on, like, the love that they have for the family supersedes all of this drug cartel, millions of dollars mess. Like, it's like, oh shit, it's Tariq. Like, hold up. And I think that that's beautiful, even though Tariq is an asshole. So then we cut back to another scene, and they show us that Tamika got fired. And she said, my black ass is out of a job. I was like, ooh, sis was bitter and mad, but you had to see that coming. A federal agent got murdered under your watch. Get out of here, sis. You're out of here. But the new district attorney is Charlotte's husband from Sex and the City. I don't know if these audience cross or not, but I loved him. And they got like a little baby in that movie and everything. So I was like, oh. Definitely good to see a recognizable face. And I know how great of an actor he is. So I'm like, ooh, this is going to be good. Sax has this whole plan to prove that whoever killed Angie was trying to kill the witness, because he leaked the information that it was a female witness. And, you know, the new district attorney basically tells him, okay, I'll let you hang yourself, but if you mess this up, you'll be in the unemployment line with the black lady. Like, he was very clear about that. And again, just more greatness to the writing of this story, because they could have just, this is things that most shows give us in like the fourth or fifth episode. This was episode 1, and I am loving it. We see Tasha coming in looking for Terry Silva. He's still missing. And you know, Tasha always serves us looks. Sis comes through in that all black, and she serves us every single time. She always looks great, no matter how much turmoil her actual life is going through. She looks amazing every single time. But while she's looking for Terry, she learns that his office, from like his office assistant or whatever, the receptionist, she's like, yeah, his family filed a missing persons report. So then it's like, oh shit, this gets real. Then we go to this scene of Ghost and Tasha in the office of the nightclub. And Ghost comes out his mouth and says, the woman I love is gone. He is standing in front of his wife, telling his wife, the woman he loves, his mistress, is gone, and how upset he is, and how he just can't think of a breathe, a function. And the entire time, I'm like, Ghost, you weren't this upset when Raina died. I'm sorry, when Raina was killed, because she was killed. You weren't this upset, but you're so distraught over Angela. I'm like, oh my gosh. And to have the audacity to say that to Tasha, it was way, way too much. But for the first time, Tasha stands up to him and she lets him know, I don't have your back this time around. You figure it out. You made this mess, you clean it up. And then she hit him with the bomb. Oh, yeah. And I want a divorce. I was like, oh, okay, Tasha.
What about how I feel? Where the fuck is Terry Silver, the man that I loved? You know, he never showed up to testify. I got a funny feeling you know exactly why.
No, I don't. The fucking truth.
I'm done. I'm done.
Wait, you gotta help me with this.
I ain't got to help you with shit.
Tosh, come on. This Tommy thing ain't going nowhere. It's not gonna be good for anyone. You know that, Tosh.
Not this time, Ghost.
What do you mean?
You made this mess. You fix it. Oh, and by the way, I want a divorce.
Then we go to see Keisha. And for the first time in 6 seasons, we finally see this son of hers she's always talking about, the little boy Cash, which I'm like, Lala's actual son is super cute. They could have used him. His name is Cayenne. I follow her Instagram. I'm like, y'all could have used Cayenne instead of this little boy. But she probably don't want her son on this crazy show, her actual son. But yeah, so we go to see Keisha and her actor son, Cash. And Cash is about to go in her bag. And, of course, Keisha wanted to be a ride or die, but being a newbie, don't even know criminal 101, you don't take it to your home and have it in your bag in reach of a minor. All it would have taken was for that little boy to pull that out there, and that would have been a whole totally different episode, you know? But she's a mess. And she, like, is trying to be all routed out. But clearly, girl, that is not your calling. So then we see Ghost and Proctor at his home. And Proctor is telling him, you know, I was wrong. It wasn't Angie, but there is another female witness. And Ghost is still, again, so distraught. He doesn't know what to do. But Proctor is telling him kind of what he's been telling him forever. You got to turn on Tommy. If Tommy did it, you got to turn on him. And Ghost hit us with a line, baby. He was like, I'm putting Tommy in a body bag, not a prison cell. The writing on this show is amazing. Like, I do not understand how these people don't have Emmys, Grammys, Oscars, Tonys, all of them. This show is amazing. Like, they deserve the recognition, man. Then we see Tommy, he in rare form. Y'all know when Tommy real, real, like, high and that adrenaline just be up there. Tommy is a live wire. We don't know what to expect. And true to his fashion, he shot Pancho dead and between his eyes, honey, and ain't even blink. And then was like, I'll see y'all later. Told the boys to clean it up. I'm like, Lord. And then Spanky or whatever his name is goes, niggas die every day, B. I'm like, oh my gosh. This show.
I'm not giving Tommy up. I'm putting Tommy in a body bag, not a prison cell. Do you read me, Joe?
I read you.
Do you?
Yes.
So then we see Tariq, old annoying, terrible ass. He comes scrolling out of the store with some damn Sun Chips and a Gatorade. That's how I'm like, boy, that's how you know you ain't even about this life, because real niggas be eating hot Cheetos. You got Harvest Cheddar Sun Chips. Low in cholesterol, good for your health. Wheat. Come on. It's not even an unhealthy snack. You're not the thug that you're trying to be. It's not it. But he comes out of the store and Tasha is standing there waiting for him. And he's like, how you know where I'm at? She's like, I'm tracking your phone. And I just laugh because that's some stuff that my mama do. Like, I could never tell her I'm anywhere because she'll pull up my track. She'll pull up that tracker real quick and be like, you right here. And it'll get me together real quick. So I thought that that was funny. And he lets Tasha know he has to go and do something that's so important with Tommy or whatever. So then we see Ghost and Proctor. Proctor finally convinced James to go to the federal office to kind of try to clear his name before they pin something on him. I particularly did not think that that was the best idea because you're not going to tell them who actually did it. All you're going to do is go in there and say, I didn't do it. And then be like, well, who did it? And then exactly what happened. We're just standing there looking at each other. They don't believe you. They don't like you. It's like, it was a good idea, sort of. It would have been a good idea had they provided something other than, hey, it's not me. Like, I don't know. So then we cut to one of the funniest scenes in the entire episode. Tommy and Tariq are on the rooftop with Kanan's ashes. And when I tell y'all, I was on the floor laughing when Tommy played that Bone Thugs Crossroads. Boom, 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 boom. I was like, oh my gosh. And what's even more funny about all of this is, if you've ever seen any interviews of the actual cast, the white actor that plays Tommy is so not like the character he plays. He is like a really like preppy white boy. And that just speaks to, I wouldn't say preppy, but he like a regular degular white boy. And for him to be able to embody that like New York accent and vibe of Tommy versus how he is in real life, y'all will understand why I say this acting on this show is a one. It's amazing. So for him to pull out Bone Thugs, I was like, this is just completely true to who and what Tommy is. And is it me? It might just be me. Tommy sprinkles ashes on the blunt and said, they gonna do it like, he was like, we gonna do it like they did Tupac. I think that that's alluding to the fact that Kanan might not be dead. I might be reaching. I'm just saying. But I'm like, why did they say that? And why was this, what's the point of them having Kanan's ashes? And I think it's all like some sort of, I don't believe it. Anyway, Tasha is then in the car with Tariq and she tells him Angela's dead after he's like, it's all that bitch's fault. Dad never would have hooked up with that bitch. And Tariq like, aren't you glad she's dead? And to see Tasha sitting there defending the woman who honestly, you know, changed her entire life, her children's lives as she knew it, for Tasha to still sit there and defend this woman knowing what this woman did for Tariq just shows the strength of Tasha and her character. Not only was she your husband's mistress and, you know, did all of these things, you are woman enough to still look at the good side and the positive things that she's done. And not only that, but defend her in her death and say, no, I wouldn't have wanted anything to happen to her. Even though when Tasha and Tommy went to her house last season, she was like, I've been waiting for this for a long time. But it's just to see that growth of like, well, you know what? She actually is trying to help us. She's helped my children. She might have ruined my marriage, but she saved my son. So we proceed through the show and a couple other things happen, but the thing that stood out the most for me after this was Ghost goes to see Paz, Angela's sister, again, and Ghost offers to pay for the funeral. And he was like, because I know you can't afford it. And the entire time I'm like, Angela is a whole lawyer out here. You AUSA Angela Valdez didn't have life insurance. You didn't have any plans. You work in a high-risk career, and you didn't have any plans for life insurances. You don't have no money set aside, sis, for your funeral. That kind of threw me off. So I'm like, where is her coin at? And you were dating a man that had money. Ghost had money. So where is your coin at, Angela Valdez? Anyway, but Paz tells Ghost, I'll get in the grave with her. I'll get in the grave with her before I let you pay for her funeral. And she actually decides to authorize the autopsy with Sax. Then we finally see Tariq kind of have a moment that is like, wow, he actually isn't this like evil ass, bratty ass, spoiled ass, wealthy black kid. He actually has a heart. And he's on the phone with Ghost and he says, you know, I didn't like her, but I'm sorry that you're upset about Angela. And it's like, again, the first time we see some decency in Tariq. But then, of course, he ruined it. And he's like, I'm just playing nice for now. Ugh. I'm like, God, this kid is terrible. And then we see Tommy go and meet with Jason. And it's just something that I really love about the character Jason. He's like this, like, just powerful, mysterious, like, silent assassin almost. Like, it's like he's not really loud. He's not even boastful, even though it's clear this man has a lot of money because he has a lot of drugs. He's supplying the drugs to Tommy. So it's like, clearly he has it. But it's just something about him, like, this silent, like, confidence and something that should just, like, evoke fear. Like, you know, he don't have to tell you he mean business, but you know you should not be playing around with him. I like Jason. But then we also see Ghost in all black lurking in the shadows, and we already know that means a problem. So we see the car, we see Tommy's car come out after Jason daps him up and hugs him. They're like, yeah, we're going to get the product. We see Tommy and Jason's guys walk to the back. The next scene, we see Ghost coming out there with that thing, boy. And he got the scope on, and he in the all black. And you know, if you've been watching for the past 6 seasons, if Ghost is in that all black, and there is a firearm present, it is not good. So I'm just like, ah, the entire time. And here come Tommy's car just coming on through. Next thing you know, like Ghost like lights the car up. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I know they did not kill Tommy and Angela in the same episode. Like, this show is crazy. But it's not shocking if they did, because that's how good power is. So I'm over there just like stuck, like no words. Only to discover Jason already knew what was coming up. That's why I'm telling y'all that power that he has, that intelligence, that like, oof, I like Jason. And Jason's like, I knew Ghost would be coming back for you. But now he's letting Tommy know, hey, this was obviously an aim to kill you. What are you going to do now? So Tommy, once again, is like in that place of feeling like, God damn it, I got to kill my brother. But Ghost walks away thinking that was Tommy in the car and that Tommy is dead. So that plays a whole new... That's a whole new card to play, because it's like, what is Ghost gonna try to do now? But I'll get into predictions on the next episode after I finish the recap. So after that, Tommy goes home to Keisha and tells her straight up, Ghost is not dead. Because her first question is Ghost dead? Which is so funny when you think about it. All of Tommy's relationships ask him that. Because Holly used to say the same thing. Are you going to kill him? Is Ghost dead yet? Like, everybody asks him the same thing. It's like, at some point, Tommy, when are you going to listen? We're all telling you that Ghost is a problem. But anyway, and he lets her know, like, no, I didn't do it, but I'm regretting that. And he's like, look, I need to send you in cash away. It's about to get crazy. And here she go, trying to be the ride or die. When she not even a ride or die, because when she threw the gun in the water, she touched it with her hand, and she was all like, oh, 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 like all obvious. A real one would have walked like you were on your phone and just walked by and just tossed that in the water, not even looking, girl, and then went out with your friend, so you had an alibi. Like, she just, amateurs. But anyway, like, Tommy tells her, look, you need to go. But she's so Miss Ride or Die that she's like, no, I'm all in. I'm with you. Anyway. So then we get to the end of the episode. And I am just so in shock. I'm super excited for whatever comes with this next, like, with these next episodes and this entire season. What are some of y'all predictions? honestly, I have so many questions. Like, is Terry Silver dead? I personally don't think that he's dead. I think that after Ghost, like, put him in a full Nelson little lock and choked him out last season, I think that when he came to, Ghost paid him off. But I think that that's going to come back later to bite him in the butt, because I think that Terry's going to have this whole moral compass about it and come back. What is Tasha's plan? Remember at dinner, she told her mom she's going to get back at Jamie because she thinks that Jamie did kill Terry because she knows that he's missing. What can she do to him that won't implicate herself or her son or Tommy? It's like, it's so intertwined. What can Tasha really do here? And what is Ghost's plan now that Angela is dead and he thinks that Tommy is dead? Me personally, my prediction, I think that he's going to now try to link up and become, because you, when you think about it, Ghost wanted to become Jamie so he could, you know, become legit to be with Angie. Well, Angie gone. So it's like, what happens now? Do you go back to being Ghost and get back in the drug game? Which I think will happen because somebody has to move all of this weight for Jason. And on top of all of that, where is Dre? Is Dre still in protective custody? If so, like, where is he being held? Whatever happened to his child's mother and the little baby? Remember last season, he was like in the middle of like getting it, like and then they came in there shooting and him and the girlfriend were still naked and the baby was in the crib. Like, where is Dre and what happened to him? And on top of that, is Angela really dead, y'all? Because if you think about it, she is in AUSA, so she's an attorney, whatever, whatever. And last season, it was mentioned, witness protection was mentioned to her. So, could this all be a plot to, like, fake her death so that she can go into witness protection and then help them get all of them on the little, like, RICO thing that they were talking about? Might be far-fetched, but a part of me just feels like, I just can't see Angie dying this quick. It's episode one! Like, it's like, a part of me just feels like there's some sort of twist. Please let me know in the comments what are some of the predictions that you have for episode two and for the entire season. What was your favorite scene? Like, what was your favorite line in the show? And also, tell me what songs y'all loved in the show as well. I love that Miguel song, R.A.N., Real Ass Nigga, that they play at the end. Such a dope song. So let me know some of the things that y'all love, some of the your favorite outfits, your favorite scenes, your favorite quotes, and your predictions. Be sure to like and subscribe to this page and join us again. We will do this each and every week to go over Power. It is a great show. So I'm going to put my energy into giving it the spotlight that it deserves because, hello, more people need to be talking about this. Everybody watches. So let's talk. Comment and like and subscribe. See you guys next week.